Hello everyone, welcome to Saroj Mathematics Tutorials. This is lecture number 4, UGC CSIR NET Number Based Problems, Part A we are discussing. So, this is the fourth part of the number based problems which we are discussing. So, the question which I have taken now is from December 2014 and this particular question has been asked for Physical Sciences and Chemical Sciences NET Part A. Question paper. Now, the question is very simple question, but we need to know the concept of this particular problem and then the problem is very easy. If n is a positive integer, then n into n plus 1 into n plus 2 into n plus 3 into n plus 4 into n plus 5 into n plus 6 is divisible by 3 but not 7, and 4 options are given. First of all, let us try to understand what this is and how it works in terms of divisibility by different numbers. Let us count how many numbers we have. First of all, n is a positive integer. Positive integer means greater than 0. As it is integer, so obviously n will be start from 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Hope this part is clear. Further, n, n plus 1, n plus 2 and all these numbers which are given in this product will also be greater than 0. Third thing, n into n plus 1, n plus 2, if we count it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 consecutive positive integers. What's special here which we can see is that these are 7 consecutive positive integers. Consecutive means one after another. So what special if we have product of positive consecutive positive integers. Suppose we have product of 2 consecutive positive integers, then must be divisible by 2. 2 will divide this product quantity if this is product of 2 consecutive positive integers. Similarly, if we move ahead, 3 will divide product of 3 consecutive positive integers and so on. So 4 will divide product of 4 consecutive positive integers. It doesn't mean that should appear like this only, n into n plus 1 into n plus 2 into n plus 3. We can also write like n plus 4 into n plus 5 into n plus 6. This will also be consecutive positive integers product and must be divisible by 2. Why? Because it is product of 3 consecutive positive integers will also be divisible by 3 and so on. We can discuss about this product now. As we have product of 7 consecutive positive integers, this is nothing but product of 7 consecutive positive integers. So what we can conclude, that what we have understood right now, according to that, what we can conclude that this product must be divisible by, let us suppose I am calling it K right now, this entire quantity is K. Then this entire quantity must be divisible by 2, must be divisible by 3, must be divisible by 4, divisible by 5, 6 will also divide the quantity and 7 will also divide the quantity. Fine. So once we are knowing that 2 is going to divide the entire quantity, 3 also, 4, 5, 6 and up to 7, all the numbers are going to divide this quantity. why it is product of 7 consecutive positive integers. So beginning from 2 up to 7, all the numbers going to divide this product quantity. So any number is given in the option, you can finally tell which one is correct. If you are aware of this concept, then any number is given here, you will quickly be able to decide which one is correct. Now let us move ahead for the option 3 but not 7. So we see that starting from 2 to 7, 3 and 7, yes, 7 but not 3, neither 3 nor 7. Now would like to mention here that in the examination this quantity may appear little bit different. Instead of n plus 6 up to n plus 8 would be given or something else. Here the numbers will be different, 3 and 7 given here, but in examination you might have 7 or 13, 11 or 9, something like that. If the concept is clear, you can quickly crack this problem. Hope it is clear. So correct answer is option B. We will move ahead for another problem. Next question which we have is again for physical sciences and chemical sciences, but useful for all. And the question is taken from December 2014 examination, NET Part A. Let's have a look on the question. A least significant bit of an 8-bit binary number is 0. A binary number whose value is 8 times the previous number has 4 options given, where first option says 12 bits ending with 3 zeros and so on. First of all, let us understand what the question says. This is number based but binary number. How many bits are there? 8 bit binary number. So 8 bit binary number, so I have made 8 boxes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 boxes are here, and we'll put binary bits here. Now 8 bit binary number means binary bits are 0 and 1. So either 0 or 1 we can fill in these boxes. Total 8 should be there. Why? Because it is given in the question, 8 bit binary number. Now a least significant bit of eight binary number is 0. Least significant bit is this one. If you look at it this way, the right hand side box, the bit present here will be the least significant bit. As per this question, it is said that the least significant bit of eight bit binary number is 0. So least significant bit is 0. So this is compulsorily 0. Rest all we can take anything. Suppose this is binary number, I am giving a name A. Let us put anything here and now I have formed up 8 bit binary number where least significant bit is 0. And I have given it a number, a name A, capital A. Now what further? A binary number whose value is 8 times the previous number. This number is called previous number, and we have to find 8 times the previous number. Means 8 times A. We need to find 8 times A. And then how 8 times A will appear? 12 bits ending with 3 zeros. 11 bits ending with 4 zeros and so on. So A is assumed, 8A has to be calculated. Once 8A is calculated, we will be able to say how it is. Hope the question is clear, sense of the question is made clear. Now let us have a quick revision of how the binary numbers are added. Suppose I have taken a small number like this. Fine. 0 plus 0 is always 0. What I am saying, 0 plus 0 is 0. And 1 plus 1 will give 10. So will be written
like this.
Fine. Let us understand few more examples. Suppose this is 3 bit. Now we are adding it. What will happen? 0 plus 0 is 1. Let's take it 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. So in this place I will write 1. 1 plus 1 is how much? 1 plus 1 we have seen 10. This will be placed here and this value, left hand side value, will be carried forward to next bits. Now again 1 plus 1 is 10 and 10 plus 1, 1 plus 1, 10, and again 10 plus 1 will be written as 1 1. So now further 1 1 we have to write because nothing is here to forward this 1. So we will write the entire quantity 11 here only. Thus we will get 1101. This example is just to understand the addition of binary bits. Now let's move ahead to find out 8A. One more thing here, there is no mechanism that we can multiply 8 with the binary number. So what we will have to do, in few steps we will reach up to 8A. There is no direct method, we will have to keep on adding and thus we will reach to 8A. So let us add it. First of all, A plus A. Just now I discussed, so quickly I will move ahead. 0 plus same A is added with itself. So this will give 2A. What we will get here will become twice of A. Now twice of A, this 1 plus 1 will give 10. 1 will be carried forward. 0 plus 0 is 0 and 0 plus 1 is 1. 0 plus 0, 0 plus 0 is 0, 1 plus 10, 1 will be carried forward. 0 plus 0 and plus 1, 1 plus 1 will give 10. Thus we have got twice A. Now, if twice A will be added with twice of A, we will be able to get 4 times A. This way we will proceed up to 8 times A. How are we going to get 4A? 2A is obtained. 2A will be added with itself and thus we will get 4 times A. So I repeat the number below it and we'll add. And we'll add it. So let us add again. How much are we going to get? 0. 0. This will give 10. So 0 plus 0 is 1. 0. 0, carry it forward 1, so this will again become 1, 1 plus 1, 10. We have reached up to 4 times A. Further, cleaning this part. So we will write 4 times A here. So 4 times A is 1, 0, 1, 3 times 0. 1 and again 3 times 0. This is what we have got, 4A. What are we trying to get is 8 times the number, that is 8A. So let us add 4A with 4A only. This number will be added with itself so that the new number formed will be 8 times 8. Now 0, 0, 0, this will give 0, 1, 0, 0, 1 and 10. Hope the addition is correct. Now let us count how many bits we have got. 8 times the previous number, 8 times the previous number we have already got. Now let us count how many bits, because the option says 12 bits, 11 bits. So let us count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. So total 11 bits and ending with how many zeros? 3 and 4 and 3. So we have got 11 bits ending with ending means this side. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 zeros at the end. Now here two important things to mention. So which one is correct option first of all? 12 bits wrong. Again 12 bits is incorrect. Ending with 3 zeros, no. This is also wrong. So 11 bits ending with 4 zeros. Option B is correct. So correct answer is option B. Now few things I would like to mention in this problem. You can take any number, you can construct any number on your own and try it on your own. But you have to keep in mind that this least significant value has to be compulsorily 0. Even after that, you might get some answers, few answers, where at the end you will see 5 zeros or you will see 6 zeros. So number of 0, two notes or remark I will mention here. Minimum number of zeros at the end will be 4. The minimum number of zeros will be 4. It can be more than 4 also. But right now options are not given. It can be 4. But not 3 of course. It will be 4 or more than 4. Number of zeros at the end. Remark number 2. Maximum length, I am talking about 8 times A, where A is 8 bit binary number ending with 0. This specific case I am talking about. And remark is for this particular case. That minimum number of zeros at the end will be 4. It can be more than 4 also in few examples, because you are going to create on your own example. Remark 2, maximum length of number 8A will be 11 bits. Because if you take any example, you will see that in some cases 8A length of bits, number of bits can be 8, 9, 10 or maximum 11. So this question is not very clearly asked. So I gave two remarks, that maximum number of bits will be 11 and minimum number of zeros at the end will be 4. Hope it is clear. So keep these two remarks in mind and then you take any number and try it on your own. So let us move ahead for next example. Let's move ahead for question number 3, again from physical sciences and chemical sciences, and the question is taken from December 2014 only, and the question says binomial theorem in algebra gives 1 plus x to the power n is equal to a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus ... an x to the power n, where a0, a1, a2, ... an are constants depending on n. So what is the sum of a0 plus a1 plus a2 ... a2 plus an? So if we are mathematics students, we are very well versed with this binomial theorem, binomial expansion we call it. Binomials means by, two terms will be there and having some power. When expansion is done, with this type of expansion we get. For example, I create one example. Suppose we have 1 plus x square. So we get a square, b square and 2ab. If we arrange it, highest power x square or the lowest power suppose, then 1 2x and x square. So what will be a0? A0 is equal to the constant here. A1 will be the constant attached with multiplied with x, that's 2, and a2 is constant multiplied with x square. So this is binomial expansion. So power can be anything like 3, 4, 5, 6, anything. So if nth power is taken, we will definitely get this type of expansion, because when n is 2, we getting up to x square. So when the power will be n, then we will get terms up to x raised to the power n. So now we'll talk about what the value of this summation. It's very easy, very simple. We'll rewrite what we are given with, or just look at it here only carefully. What we need is a0 plus a1 plus a2 plus dot 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 up to an. Let us assume if we take x is equal to 1, we are free to put the value, we are free to take any value of x. Let us assume that we take x equal to 1. How this right hand side will appear? If this is equation number 1, we call it equation right now, binomial expansion. If we take x equal to 1, LHS will appear as a0, sorry, right hand side will appear as, this side will appear as a0 plus a1 into 1 plus a2 into 1 whole square plus an 1 raised to the power n. Any power given to 1 will give 1. And finally, we will be able to see . So this is the RHS value of equation 1. Now what about LHS? Putting x equal to 1, we will have obviously both the sides are equal and will remain equal whatever value we take x equal to 1. For x equal to 1 also, LHS will be equal to RHS. So what we can say that LHS is equal to RHS, and hence a0 plus a1 plus a2 up to an is nothing but 2 to the power n. So thus we have got the value of a0 plus a1 up to n summation. This is equal to 2 to the power n. Just find out where it is. This is option 1, option A. Rest all will be incorrect. So correct answer is . Hope this is very clear. Binomial expansion, mathematics student will find it very easy. Others will also understand it. So let's move ahead for another question. Next question from December 2014. The question is for mathematical sciences, life sciences and earth sciences. This particular question I am talking about. And the question says, question number 4 of this lecture, if N, E and T are distinct positive integers such that N into E into T is equal to 2013, then which of the following is the maximum possible sum of NET? So we are given with 4 options are given. So let's see what is given. NET are distinct positive integers, and N into product of NET given. Product is given, which is equal to 2013, and we have to find N plus E plus T maximum value. when the question talks about maximum value, it means there must be more than one values of this sum n plus e plus t. So we will find out how can we split up 2013. We will move ahead for prime factorization of 2013. Clearly this is not divisible by 2, this is not an even number. So we will try to divide it with 3. Let's divide it with 3. 6, 71. Further, if we look at it carefully, is divisible by 11. 11 is also prime number. So 11, 6 and 61. Further, 61 is not divisible by any other number because 61 is prime number. So 2013 can be written as, in how many ways we can write 2013 as product of 3 numbers. In how many ways we can write 2013 as a product of 3 numbers, and these 3 numbers should be different, distinct, positive integers. So repetition is not allowed, and then we have to split it as. Why I am saying this? Because we can write like this also, 2013 into 1 into 1. So this is not allowed because all the values have to be distinct. So this will be wrong. Other than this, how can we present 2013 as product of 3? So we can certainly write 3 into 11 into 61. Is this the final? Is this the only way or the final way we can write 2013 as product of 3 numbers? No. We can write it as 3 into 11, 33 into 61, and 1 we can consider as third number, third quantity. This is also possible. Fine. Next we can write it as 3 into 61. How much it is? 183 and 11 and 1. Any other way we can find? 3 into 11 is done, 3 into 61 is done. So let us try 11 into 61. So 11 into 61 is obviously 671. So now we have 3 into 671 into 1. So these are 4 ways in which 2013 can be written as product of 3 numbers. The 4 ways will be considered one by one for n plus e plus t, because we have to find out the maximum value of n plus e plus t. So first, this one, n plus e plus t, value I am calculating. Very first, 3, this will be taken as n, e and t. So n is 3, 11 and 61. How much it is? 75. Let's find out next one. So this is 33 plus 61 plus 1. So we'll give how much? 95. Third is 183 plus 11 plus 1. So this will give 195. Fourth one is 3 plus 3 plus 671 plus 1. How much it is? This is going to give 675. So 5 values of n plus e plus t available with 75, 95, 195 and 675. Out of these four values, which one is maximum? This one is maximum. We can see 75, 95, 195 and 675. This is the biggest quantity. The question asked about maximum possible sum of NEP. However, four possibilities, but maximum one is 675, which is available as option C. So the final answer is, correct answer is option C, 675. Hope the question is clear. This thing has to be taken care of. No number will be repeated. So that's all about this problem. So we'll be back with lecture number 5. More problems, number based CSIR NET examination, useful for all CSIR NET examination students, preparing students. So keep watching, keep sharing my videos, and if you like my videos, please subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.